Knock, knock.
Who's that?
Marta.
Like that hole.
Marta Vision subscribe.
Okay, that's not funny.
Marta Vision subscribe.
Hello there, I welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. I'm a game developer. I develop games for Android and iOS and other stuff. And today we are making Iron Man, or at least something that looks like it. It's a bit pixelated. Alright, so let me show you this demo. Let's run the demo. I'm running Windows 10. There's the main character. He can walk, and if you press spacebar, he can jump. Okay, now I'm going to jump and use my thrusters. Alright, so you can follow along this tutorial by opening the example file, which you will find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using, there is also a link down below where you can get a free copy. Now, there is also a paid copy of this software, which is for commercial purposes. Okay, so let's open the example file. And if you run this, you're going to notice that you can move your character and jump. You can actually double jump by pressing spacebar a bunch of times, okay? But you notice that we have no jets, okay? Let's fix that. All right, so let me go over this scene very quickly. This is the platform object. This is what I'm using. And I'm going to double click on him. Let me show you all the animations I'm using. This is the stop animation. There's the walking animation. Very simple. And here is the jumping animation. And really, that's all we need. Here is the jets. They're also animations. This is the background, this is just a background, and I'm using this line here as a ground line, okay? This is not visible at start. Okay, so let's create the rocket. Don't worry, there is no programming in this software. Let's go to the event editor. You can see that I already created some events to get our character jumping and walking. Alright, so let's scroll down to line 10, okay? Upon pressing spacebar, object isn't standing on the ground, okay? We are going to play a sound. Here's our sound effect. Let's try it out. Press spacebar. You can see that works right away. We also want to create a one of those jets. Okay, so I'm going to select this one. And we're going to place it somewhere around here below his feet. Okay, let's try it out. You can see that works not too bad. Now, when the jet finished the stop animation, we can destroy it. Animation stop is over. Then we destroy the object. That works not too bad. I'm going to create an always under special condition.
And we are going to set the position of the jet relative to Iron Man. And that kind of works already. Except for if you turn around. So we are going to replace this for
Iron Man is facing right.
Straight out. That works not too bad. If he's facing left, then we change the position somewhere around here. Straight out. Oops, it's gotta go a little bit over there. And that doesn't look too bad. Now, to create the second one, you could do it by ID, but why complicate life? I simply created another jet, and under line 10, we simply create another object, jet 2, right below his feet. There is, thread out. That works fine. Let's clone this here. I'm gonna copy this line, copy, paste, replace the object for jet 2. And instead of destroying, we're gonna destroy this second jet. So all I had to do is drag this over and delete that. Right out. That works fine. Now the position facing right. Position will be somewhere around here. That works not too bad. Now for the left position. That doesn't look too bad there. So you can see that this is extremely simple. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter. Like the video. And I will see you in the next episode.